Hi, welcome to Hot Takes. This is Kyle with Music as a Verb, and today I'm going to be listening to Watermelon Sugar by Harry Styles. As always, I'm going to develop a list of qualities while I listen to the song, some of the theory and production and songwriting techniques that I think they use to help me better understand the song. In my next video, I'll take that list of qualities and try to build a track that's something like Watermelon Sugar. I hope you enjoy. All right, this is Watermelon Sugar by Harry Styles.
Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds just like a song.
Bassline.
I want more berries and that summer feeling.
Six,
one, it's so wonderful and warm.
Five.
Breathe me in.
All right, so we have a kind of cool progression that starts on the two chord, re, and I think it's like a minor seventh chord. This is in the key of re. So this is in the key of C major-ish. It starts on a D minor chord, and I'm hearing a D minor seven, something like this. And I'm hearing that strummed on the guitar, right? So that sounds good. Two, six, one. And I'll play it as kind of those upper four-string chords on an electric guitar. I like that sound. It's pretty laid back in the background.
Breathe me out.
Get a filtered drum group coming in, a little halftime.
If I could ever go without, I'm just thinking out loud.
Bass. Extra low octave voice comes in. Ooh. So there's cool stuff about to happen, but I should talk about that little vocal break. Let's hear that again. Oh, those are like full chords harmonized, right? So, and watermelon sugar, and also, watermelon sugar, and also watermelon sugar, but all together, so like, that's pretty cool. Watermelon sugar, and it just really punctuates that chord. And then back into our groove, right? That's pretty cool. Let's hear what comes next.
Watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar strawberries.
Interesting.
I want your belly. And it's summer.
So. So.
Watermelon sugar, strawberries. On a summer evening. Baby, you're the end of June. I want your belly. And it's summer feeling.
Cool. So we get these kind of guitar fills in between the chords. So two, dee da 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 da, six, dee da 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 dee, one, dee da 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 da, five. Pretty cool. Pretty cool guitar fills leading into each chord, which I really like. It changes up the feeling of that, even though the chord progression hasn't changed. It's giving us something interesting in between to keep our ear engaged. Something that a lot of songs don't do, and they're giving us an extra layer for that second verse. That's interesting too. So this is a really basic melody, right? I mean, we're... So da 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 da. I mean, so far two notes. Da 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 da. Literally two notes that for that melody in the entire chorus, but they're matching the chords really well, right? So da 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 da. over the two chord, and that's a two note. Da 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 da. Over the six chord, and we get a chord tone. Da 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 da. Over the one, and then da 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 da. Over the five. So they're taking those two notes, this little repeated melodic pattern, right? The simplest possible melodic pattern with two notes. And they're making it work over the chord progression in a way that really punctuates that chord progression. In fact, one of the best things that you can do learning music are taking these small little melodic patterns or pairs of two or three notes and following them through a chord progression. So in a way, this is a really nice guide tone through the chord progression, just using these two notes, but always landing on the one that makes sense for the chord we're on. Beyond that, they're also creating a really great rhythmic figure. Yup-a-pa-pa-pa-pa-ba. Yup-a-pa-pa-pa-ba. Right, these 16th notes followed by just this big punch after the fact. Yup-a-pa-pa-pa-ba downbeat. Yup-a-pa-pa-pa-ba. 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 And it creates a real punch to that chorus, right? Shika-tika-tika. Bam! It creates that big, big hit when it comes in. I could easily see a stop time part of this song, which I don't think really ever happens, right? But I want to hear it. I want to hear yup-a-pa-pa-pa-pa, bow! Yup-a-pa-pa-pa-na, bow! Yup-a-pa-pa-pa-pa, bow! Yup-a-pa-pa-pa-pa-pa, yup-a-pa-pa-pa-da, bow! I want to hear that stop time chorus with like some lead, you know. I really want to hear it. I think that would be a cool thing to do with this type of rhythm. Let's hear where it goes from here. Ya da 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 da. Ooh, that's cool. A really cool melody choice leading back into the same old chords. Woo! Hi. Ooh, that's cool. And that's over the five chord. So, ooh, we get this really cool, like, add nine chord there. Walk sugar high. And back to re, probably after that. Let me listen to that chord again. And then, ooh, I think the seven's in there too. Hi. Let's hear if that note's in there. Hi. 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 Ooh, I think it is. That makes that chord this. That's really cool. Like a G dominant nine, right? A nine chord. That is really, really cool. Harmony going right there. It feels like it very much should go to one there, right? So. So D, Re, Fa, La. And I want to hear it go to one, but it's not going to. It's going to go back to re, a real Dorian sound, right? If we have this big, big G 7-9 chord, and then that's going to go back to a D minor. It really feels almost like we're landing home. Let's keep going. Like a song. I want your belly and that summer feeling. I don't know. That's cool. You play that along with that. Song grooves. Feels so good with the drum. Feels great. Horn lines. let's see if we get our G9 again.
Woo!
Yeah, what a cool chord choice. And then we get that great ending again to the with all those chords going, watermelon sugar, watermelon sugar, watermelon sugar. It's a great way to end the track, right? Really punches the ending. Alright, so that's Watermelon Sugar by Harry Styles. In my next video, I'm gonna take all of the techniques that I talked about here and try to build a track layer by layer to sound sonically something like Watermelon Sugar did. In the meantime, please remember to like and subscribe to the channel. And if you like videos like these, suggest another hot take. What should my next one be? I'll see you soon.